Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Thank you so much, Martha, for, and you're going to try to take this and copy, and I'm going to be moving around, and that's going to be really tricky, isn't it? I'll try to stay still. thank you very much for having me here. Thank you very much for welcoming me in, and especially this special time we're commissioning Kathy as she goes on to her next calling ministry. So I'm Dawn Davis, and a faith formation coordinator for the Greater St. Catharines area, and privileged to be in that position and to be part of this spiritual journey for so many in this area. But I thought what I'd do is just start by seeing if what's going on with the Acts, because this is your last of this series. So, this is not to test you, but I just want to see how it's been going. So, here's a few little questions. Who wrote the Book of Acts? Not that Luke. So, yeah, Luke, right? So, Luke, Acts is actually book two of this, from this writer called Luke. And so there's two, but it gets divided in the Bible, because there's Matthew, Mark, Luke, and then there's John, and then the book of Acts, right? So these they actually originally came together, and they were split up. So you've got that one writer writing the book of Luke, the Gospel of Luke, and then the book of Acts. Now, if you had to say that the book, the Gospel of Luke, is about Jesus, right? That tells the story of Jesus' birth. We're going to hear all from Luke for the next year, and we're going to definitely hear about from Luke at Christmas, because he's a big one around Jesus' birth. So the Gospel of Luke is all about Jesus. The Book of Acts, what's that been about? The Holy Spirit, way to go. Absolutely right. And how the Holy Spirit enlivened and empowered people to come together and form the church. What you're doing tonight is what the Book of Acts is about, is people coming together and trying to be church, trying to be the community, trying to be the body of Christ. So it pretty much picks up the whole of the early church after Jesus dies, right? And is resurrected, and kind of what happens next. So, tonight, just one more last question. In all the studying that you've been doing, or the tracing of the stories in Acts, has the church had a really smooth time of it? No. Right? Lots of controversy, lots of real wrestling, lots of out-and-out conflict. One particular one is between the two disciples. Can you name them? The really big rift that's divided the early church. Peter and Paul. And they wrestle it out because Paul says that Jesus' message is meant for the world, including Gentiles. And Peter says, I think that it's just meant for the Jewish tradition. And this gets wrestled out. And, of course, Paul wins out. And Peter has a vision, and here we are. So, what you heard today was the weirdest ending ever. So if you get a chance to leaf through your Acts and see where we are, you're in chapter 28. It's at the end. And to me, it's this kind of, oh, it just kind of comes to an end. What has happened is Paul's in a heap of trouble because this church is starting to be persecuted. The Jewish community is calling this Christian, these followers, the Way, some kind of sect. And they're getting really, really nervous about them. And so Paul is imprisoned. He's in custody. And he says, hang on, I am a Roman citizen. I'm Jew, but I'm a Roman citizen. So I can't be convicted by the Jewish authorities. So they've taken him to Rome. He's in Rome, and he is trying to explain rationally to the people that are around him why they are wrong and why they should believe in Jesus. And they come to his place, and he talks at them, and he's reasoning with them for a whole day. And he quotes a little bit from Isaiah and says, kind of like, I give up on you. Your hearts are dull, your ears are stopped, your eyes are blind, you can't see the truth. But here's the thing. When he went to Rome, there were already believers. They had believers came to him, and it seemed like, from the story, there were those that did get converted, that did come to have a sense of Jesus and understand what Paul was saying. So I'm going to throw this one out to you. How did you get converted? How were you convinced that Jesus was the way, or that you would follow a Christian way of being in your spirituality? Was it a reasoned, thought-out process? Was it an encounter with Scripture? Was it kind of just living into a way within your family and tradition? Was it an encounter and an experience at some point in your life with the God that Jesus revealed to us? Of that? Is there anyone brave enough to say what that, how they came to encounter their faith? Wow.
Very often. The main thing that brought me back is all the alternatives to the Christian way all seemed very stupid.
It
didn't seem...
It didn't click. It didn't click for you.
So I eventually became fully involved in my parish.
Would you say it was a reasoned, thought-through process? Uh-huh. Okay. Thank you. Anyone else? I want to know what you're having for breakfast, because you do not.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. And I grew up in the Anglican faith, so, my parents were not initially, but they were certainly part of the Anglican faith for a long time. So were my grandparents on both sides. So, that became, but in terms of actual seeing what faith can do, I guess it's pretty personal to me. But when my father was dying, our rector at the time was performing last rites, and he said, my dad's name was Ken. Ken, are you ready to receive the Lord to come? And he, without any hesitation, said yes. He knew what was happening. I'm sure he had some questions, but that was a to me, a big testament of faith. And it stayed with me. I think Dad died quite a long time ago now. That stayed with me for all these years. So, anyway, there we are.
And his experience has formed your experience.
Yeah, that's right.
And each one is precious. Some will be formed through reason, some through others' experience, some through an encounter that you've had personally. Some kind of thing you just can't explain that happens, a presence of something. Hold on to those, know those, and claim them. Because that's what, in the end, Paul was trying to explain to the people. And that's really, in the end, what the book of Acts is all about, is knowing that which has come to meet you that brings life and renewal and a promise of forgiveness and a chance to try again, that will allow us to live more fully than we could ever imagine, and that unites us as a community of faith. So congratulations for completing your book of Acts. May you continue on your journey of deepening and growing as disciples of Christ. Amen.